What is up, guys? Today we have another mock draft Monday. We are going to be doing a two-round mock draft. It's my first one, two-round on the channel. And with that said, also, this will probably be my second-to-last mock draft. I'll probably continue with the mock draft Mondays. I'll have some more content for that next Monday and then the week after. But we're finally in the month of the NFL draft, so we don't have a whole lot of time. And I'll do one probably right before the draft, like the week before, and that'll probably be it. Because I think after this week, we have 2 weeks, and then that third week would be the draft week. So, with that said, let's go ahead and get started with this video. Okay, so here we are. Carolina Panthers on the clock. They traded up. With this, we are going to be taking C.J. Stroud. You know, Bryce Young's probably the better quarterback, but at the moment, C.J. Stroud looks like the pick. He's got a lot of fans in Carolina, and there are apparently some that like Bryce Young in Carolina too, but C.J. Stroud's been the main talking point, and they really showed up for his pro day. They brought the whole crew out, and, you know, you saw, like, the owner dapping up C.J. Stroud, so, I mean, you know, looks like it's heading towards C.J. Stroud for the moment. This draft is going to be based on kind of a mix of what I think should happen and what seems to be the trends in the NFL right now. So, C.J. Stroud, 1. 2, Bryce Young. Pretty much, I think these two picks are locked in. It's just which order will they go in. You could see Bryce Young going number 1, C.J. Stroud going number 2, but that's it. And really, I think the third pick is pretty much locked into in Will Anderson. If you watch my video from yesterday, you'll see that 3 could be a spot where somebody trades up. I don't know who. Probably 5, 6, or 7. Maybe even the Titans. But right now, as it sits, if the Cardinals stick and pick, they're going to get Will Anderson. I just don't see it another way. Then, at 4, I'm going to go with Anthony Richardson. I really see Will Levis as a Colt, but this is the consistent pick right now. So, I'm just going to stick with that. I'm not trying to just copy everybody else. I'm just trying to, you know, go with what I really feel like it might happen in this draft as it sits right now. Number 5, you know, there's a lot of ways they could go here. You know, there's plenty of, I mean, if they wanted to go to the quarterback route with Will Levis, I wouldn't be shocked, honestly. But they're not going to do that. And also, Jalen Carter has some off-field issues. So we're going to go with Tyree Wilson. Kind of put somebody on that edge. They don't really have a whole lot there. They have Boye Mafe, and I really can't think of anybody else right now. So Tyree Wilson, be a good pick for them. The Detroit Lions, they're going to land Jalen Carter. You know, he could fall farther, but if he gets to Detroit, they have such a bad interior defensive line. They have Alim McNeil and then Isaiah Bugs, I think. So, I mean, that's a pick they just kind of need to make and upgrade that room for good. Next is going to be Will Levis. You know, they have a lot of needs, but they're kind of gearing up for the future. Jimmy G's their guy right now. Will Levis can take some time, sit back, relax, and learn to play the quarterback position behind him. Then the Atlanta Falcons. We're going to have them taking, this one's actually a tough one now that I'm thinking about it. The Atlanta Falcons, I'm going to have them taking Devin Witherspoon. You know, he's just a good corner, and they need somebody back there to boost up that secondary. They've made a lot of signings in free agency to go with their front 7. They made Calais Campbell signing recently. Grady Jarrett's there. They got Caden Ellis from New Orleans and a few others. What's the other name? Can't remember his name right now. Also from New Orleans, though. I'll think of his name in a minute. I'll just tell you. But either way, Chicago Bears, Peter Skoronski. Well, yeah, I'm going to go with something different, actually. Yeah, let's switch it up this time. Broderick Jones. Probably the highest upside of all the tackles, but also the lowest floor. But that's something I think the Bears can take a risk on. He could be the best player at the position. Could be one of the best players in this draft class. And so I'm going to take him and sit back with that. Next is Christian Gonzalez. This has been a pick that I've had for a long time. And, you know, for a while I was like, okay, they brought back Bradbury. They brought back Slay. Maybe not this anymore. Actually, I kind of make it want me to do it more because he's pretty raw. Christian Gonzalez is kind of raw. So bringing back those two veterans will give him some time to play in the role that he doesn't have to be the number one guy. He can learn from two really good corners. I mean, Bradbury was the best corner in the league last year statistically, and Darius Slay is it's Darius Slay. So, you know, that is a pretty big step up right there. And next we're going to have Quentin Johnston going to, I did not mean to click that, Quentin Johnston going to the Tennessee Titans. Their wide receiver room is a bowl of hot garbage, so getting him would be a huge upgrade really fast. Next, the Houston Texans. And this pick is, you know, really good for them because they just can go anywhere they want with this. And I'm going to have them going Miles Murphy. They really need to fix that D-line. And, you know, edge players are kind of the high priority for NFL teams. So that is going to be the reason I take Miles Murphy. And then after that, we're going to have the Jets on the board. And, you know, I kind of thought this would be a pick in the Aaron Rodgers trade, but that apparently is not what it's going to be right now. That has kind of fallen out of the loop, and Rodgers is not going to be traded for a first at the moment. So I'm going to have them taking Peter Skoronski. You know, locking up that side. They have Mekhi Becton when he's healthy on the right side, and so him on the left would be great. That'd be great bookend tackles. Next, the New England Patriots. This is a little different one, but I'm going to go with Joey Porter Jr. They really need some corner help. Have had a lot of issues with corners recently, and so getting them somebody who can just really lock down that side, play good man defense. The problem with Joey Porter Jr. is he's kind of slow, but, you know, there's not everybody's perfect, so you got to have something somewhere. And then the Packers, you know, they look right here, they need a lot of things, not really quarterback, they got Jordan Love right now, but Jaxon Smith-Njigba will be their slot receiver for the future. Having him, Romeo Doubs, and Christian Watson is a great trio, a great young trio for a guy like Jordan Love to just develop with for a long time. Then, get out of there. Then we're going to have, this is going to be a different pick, something that I don't feel like has happened too much. I'm going to have the Commanders going with Michael Mayer. They have Logan Thomas, who can't stay on the field, and Michael Mayer is a really solid, really just all you want in a tight end. He's, you know, he can block, he can catch, he can run after catch a little bit. You know, he's got it all. He's really the prototypical tight end. And, you know, maybe it's not the biggest position in need, but a really good player to go to a team that really needs some help in that position because they can't have a guy who can stay healthy. And also, just trying to be a little different. And this perfectly works out where Paris Johnson Jr. falls to the Steelers. I think that's the guy they really want, but they don't think they can get him. And, you know, they probably can't unless it shakes out just like this. So that's a great pick for them. After that, we will have the the Detroit Lions going with, where is he? Nolan Smith. You know, they picked up Aiden Hutchinson last year. Now they have Nolan Smith on the other side, and they have Jalen Carter in the middle. They're really building the defense, going to make every team just put them all in pain. So, you know, that will be a really high-end pickup for them to try and get a severely good athlete at the position. Then the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are going to go with Dalton Kincaid. They really need a tight end. They lost O.J. Howard, I believe, and Cameron Brate is, I don't know what happened to him. I think he's gone. I don't even remember, though. Either way, Dalton Kincaid is a really good player. He's almost a receiver at tight end. They use him a lot in the slot at Utah, and he ran a ton of routes. Hasn't played football for the longest time, though. So, you know, that's what's going to put him here in 19. Great athlete, though, completely. And then to Seattle. Earlier, we had them taking Tyree Wilson. And this pick is going to be a bit different. This guy's been creeping into the draft boards really heavily, and he has went from being like a third-round pick to being a first-round pick. And if you watched my video from yesterday, you know who that is already. Hendon Hooker. Call me crazy, whatever, but he's really creeped back up. He is going to be a 25-year-old rookie, and so that's an issue to a point. But at the same time, in the NFL, quarterbacks play for far longer than they used to. Most players, Dalton Kincaid, I mean, Paris Johnson, Nolan Smith, those positions, when they hit, you know, they're 22, 23. When they hit 10 years in the league and they're 32, 33, they're pretty much done for the most part. Quarterbacks, you know, he's 25 when he comes into the league. Quarterbacks play till they're 36, 37. He has the same amount of time as every other position does in the league, essentially. So I don't think that's a huge issue. Plus, they can let him sit, really teach him the position in the NFL, and get a guy like Geno one more year before they put Hendon Hooker out there. Then next, we have the L.A. Chargers, who I'm going to have taking corner Deontay Banks. I didn't mean to click that once again. Great job. Deontay Banks, really fast corner, tested out of the room at the combine, and I just think that's going to be a good pickup for them because J.C. Jackson did not work out completely for them. Then we have Lucas Van Ness going to Baltimore. He's just a giant muscle, one big muscle. He really screams Baltimore football to me. So get them a guy who just will be there for a long time and be very good at that position. Then we have Jordan Addison. To me, he's the second best receiver in this class. I like Quentin Johnson over him, but then Jordan Addison's next, second. I don't think his pro day or combine is going to be that big of an issue. But either way, you know, say what you want about it. It's, you know, whatever you like to think, it's fine. Next, we have Brian Branch. They need help in the secondary in Jacksonville, and Brian Branch can bring that. He's versatile. He can play around the position. So definitely think that'd be a good pickup for them. Zay Flowers to the Giants. They need a receiver. End of story. I mean, I don't think you have to say tons about that. Their receiver room is pretty awful right now. Next, Dallas gets Kalijah Kancey. You know, they need some interior D-line help, and he is an athlete. And so I think that'd be pretty scary to have to face him, Michael Parsons, DeMarcus Lawrence, and everybody else on that defense right now. After that, we're going to go with DeJuan Jones to Buffalo. They tried the Spencer Brown project. Didn't really work. So I think this will be a good way for them to just hunker down in one position and try to fix that run game before it gets beyond repair. Then is a nice fancy pick, Bijan Robinson. Joe Mixon has some off-field issues right now, and also he wasn't very good. They deferred to Samaje Perine in the playoffs for the last 2 years. So find a back that can replace Joe Mixon, be actually worth it, and also he's younger, gonna have him. I think there's high benefit in taking a running back in the back of the first round, because in the second round, you don't get that rookie fifth-year option. You get it here, so you have effective control of a player for 6 years. That's about as long as the lifespan of a good NFL running back is, 6 years. Because you have their 4 years on contract, and then you have the fifth-year option, and then the franchise tag if you need to. So you have 6 years of control. Take him, keep him for 6 years, and then if he's probably run his course by then, he's gone. Next, Brian Brisee. Has some issues, didn't pop off the screen a whole lot in college, but that was a lot of off-field things, not any character issues, but like he had the loss of his sister. And so, you know, that makes him harder. I mean, I'm sure it had effect on his play. And so, but either way, he's still a really solid player, and the Saints need a huge upgrade in that interior of the defensive line. So, you know, get somebody who will definitely fix that position for them. Next, we have a little bit more of a fancy pick again. Where's he at? Jahmyr Gibbs to the Eagles. Same reason as earlier. He's probably, you know, a first-round player as well in terms of talent. He's a very good running back. Plus, he fits their system a lot. Can catch a lot of passes out of the backfield. A solid runner as well. He's really just Bijan Robinson light in a way. I mean, he's not as good of a runner as Bijan, but still. Really good pass catcher. And I think that'd really fit with Philly's offense. And so, you know, you also get 6 years of control on his timeline. So that is just very beneficial. And then the Chiefs are going to have a bit of a different pick here. Mozzie Smith, you know, fix that D-line, you know, get a good run defense going. You have Chris Jones, but he's getting a little older. Mozzie Smith come in. He's a really good athlete, play the position very well. Starting round two, Pittsburgh Steelers up on the clock, and they are going to take linebacker Drew Sanders. He is a versatile linebacker, can play the edge, can play inside, and the Steelers have really tried to fix that position and get a lot of physicality. Plus, if you need him to play the edge, give him some rotation snaps for when TJ and Highsmith need to rotate out. Sounds great to me. After that, we're going to have a couple picks in really quick. Anton Harrison, just to get another tackle aside of Laremy Tunsil. And then Emmanuel Forbes. The Cardinals defense is pretty horrible. They got Will Anderson earlier. Emmanuel Forbes on the back end. Just kind of give you some position stability throughout the defense, for sure. Next, we have Josh Downs going to the Colts. You know, they have Michael Pittman, and that is about it. I mean, the receivers, they lost Paris Campbell. They have Alec Pierce from last season, but give them another guy, put him in the slot, let Pittman and Pierce run the outsides. That'll be pretty good, in my opinion. Cam Smith to the Rams. They lost, obviously, they lost Jalen Ramsey, and so giving them another corner to use and actually be a good player at the position will be a great addition as well. Then we have a couple guards are going to go off right here. Osiris Torrance will go to the Seahawks, the best guard in the class. It's not close. He honestly is shocking he made it this far. But you know, really good player, Osiris Torrance. I mean, he ate up Jalen Carter and when they played Florida. So I think that's a really solid pickup for them. And then Steve Avila had a really good season this past year. A little older, has a lot of experience. And, you know, the Raiders, just their offensive line is not very good aside from their left tackle, who I'm completely blocking his name right now. Either way, that makes me mad. I can't think of his name. Either way, you know, really good upgrade for their offensive line in general. And I think that's just something they need to do to prepare for the future. Next, we are going to have a bit of a different pick as well. Where is he at? I know he's here somewhere. Come on. Jalin Hyatt is going to go to the Panthers. If they got the first overall pick, they've signed DJ Moore and Adam Thielen, or DJ Charkham, excuse me, and Adam Thielen, but giving Jalin Hyatt kind of a change of pace receiver, burner, you know, some guy who's going to just fly up the field and let potentially, who was it, Anthony Richardson, just throw the ball a billion miles in the head. Or, excuse me, CJ Stroud, not Anthony Richardson. But yeah. And then after we have Jalin Hyatt go off the board, you know, the Saints have got to find something for their defense, and they're going to take Adetomiwa Adeboye, or I don't know how to say it exactly. Either way, the guy who jumped out of the building at the combine, ran like a 4.49 or something like that as an edge rusher who's like 260 or something. Just great combine performance, and they need something to add up that side. Plus, they got Brian Bercy. They got a guy on the interior, got a guy on the edge. Cam Jordan can play, you know, around the other side. Be a great addition for their lackluster defense at this point. Then the Titans, they are going to be able to snag a good tackle here. Darnell Wright. Maybe a right tackle, but a tackle nonetheless. They lost Taylor Lewan. They cut him. And just they are really needy at that position. So something that I think will be very effective for them. And before we get to this Jets picks, you know, these are kind of tough because I think one or both of these might be the compensation for Aaron Rodgers. So they may not have them, but Aaron Rodgers hasn't been traded, and in my other mock drafts, I always traded the picks for the Packers, but this one we're not going to. We're just going to kind of sit and pick because who knows what's going to happen with that situation. It's Aaron Rodgers. So we're going to go with the first pick being, where is he at? Trenton Simpson. Their linebacking core is pretty rough, and I think they got, who was it? Who did I give them? Peter Skoronski earlier. And so, you know, finding them another guy who can be on the offensive line is probably a highly beneficial thing for them. I mean, that was good for the offensive line pick earlier, but now they need to fix that defense. And that linebacker pick is something they really need on the defense. Probably their most needed position defensively, honestly. So then after that, we're going to take Will McDonald for the edge. They have, I'm blanking on his name too. John Franklin Myers on the edge, and he's a big edge rusher, but you know, Quinnen Williams and stuff. And then I kind of assume that with the Rodgers trade, that if they don't trade these picks, they're probably going to lose a player like Jermaine Johnson, some young player in that type of level. And I think Will McDonald will be a solid replacement for that. So that kind of leads me to taking Will McDonald there. And next we'll have another defensive player coming off the board for the Falcons, and that is going to be B.J. Ojulari. The Falcons have made a lot of improvement on the interior of their defensive line. Earlier they picked a corner, and now they solidify their edge with B.J. Ojulari, a solid player out of LSU. And then we're going to have the Packers, where's he at, going with Antonio Johnson. You know, they don't have the best safeties. Adrian Amos is old, and Darnell Savage is an okay player, but Antonio Johnson would be a solid addition there, helping that defensive secondary out a lot. Then the Patriots, you're going to take Dayan Henley. He's a very solid player at the linebacker position. He's a very good coverage linebacker, and I think that's just something the Patriots don't really have right now. So give them a different type of guy there, and also pretty rough linebacking core currently. They have Jelani Tavai, and then I can't think of his name, but I can see his face. But either way, I think he'd be a good addition to their linebacking core. Next, we got Tyrique Stevenson from Miami going to the Washington Commanders. They have a pretty rough secondary. I mean, it's not terrible. They have Kendall Fuller, and then they have Ben St. Juice, basically. But that's the only things I really like in their secondary. Cam Curl is a fine, strong safety, but giving them some depth at corner is definitely a need for almost every team. You can't really ever have too many corners. Then we're going to have the Detroit Lions taking Jack Campbell. They really like need this draft to go well. And I think for this draft to go well, they need first to take Jalen Carter, then to take either Dalton Kincaid or another guy to help the defense. And then in the second round, they need a linebacker and a corner. And so here they knock that linebacker spot right off the board and getting a maybe the best true middle linebacker in this class. Jack Campbell is just a big guy who's just going to smack you across the mouth. And I think that's just a good addition to that biting your knees or ankles defense that Dan, what is his name? The coach likes to run. Wow, I'm blanking on it every single name today. So, you know, great. Dan Campbell. There we go. Next, we're going to have the Pittsburgh Steelers. They got a tackle earlier and then a linebacker, and now they're going to get a corner in Garrett Williams. You know, they need some help there. Levi Wallace and Akello Witherspoon are fine, but for the future, you got to have somebody who's going to actually be able to play the position and play it well. Garrett Williams is a pretty good player, and I like that pick for the Steelers. Then we have Tanner McKee going to the Buccaneers. They lost Tom Brady, obviously. They signed Baker Mayfield. Baker Mayfield, I like Baker. He's a good player, I think. I think he's definitely one of the top 25 quarterbacks in the league, probably between 20 and 25, but I think you got to give him at least that much. And Tanner McKee is going to come in and sit around for a while and wait and learn the position and, excuse me, maybe hopefully be the guy for the future in Tampa Bay. After that, we're going to go with a couple centers are going to come off the board here pretty quick. The best one is obviously going to go first, and that is going to be John Michael Schmitz. Dolphins could definitely use a legitimate center, and he is the best one in the class, and I think it's not very close. After that, we have Joe Tippmann, wherever he's at. Joe Tippmann is, you know, a really interesting player as well from Wisconsin. He loved the mullet, so and there's a huge need for center in Seattle, so I would definitely like that there. And then finally, Luke Whipler, I don't know how to pronounce it exactly, but he goes to the Bears. They also need a center. All right, so after that, we've got the Chargers on the board, and they are going to add a little bit of just versatility and get Nathaniel Tank Dell. You know, they have Mike Williams and they have Keenan Allen, and I like those guys both on the sides. And then you can play Tank Dell on the center and the slot position, and, you know, I think that would be a really good addition for their offense and just to get some youth in that receiving room because it has gotten pretty old pretty quick. After that, the Detroit Lions, you know, they got to get their corner, like I just said. So Julius Brents being on the board works out well. They did sign Emmanuel Mosley and Cam Sutton in free agency, but you got to have some depth and you got to have some youth. So bringing in Julius Brents, who's a big corner, will be a really solid pickup for them, I believe. After that, we're going to go with the Jaguars taking Luke Musgrave, a pretty good tight end. I think he'd be maybe even closer to the first round if we didn't have two really solid tight ends in this class in Dalton Kincaid and Michael Meyer. And, you know, I think he's a pretty good player, but those two guys are just far and away really, really good tight ends, really good players at the tight end position, let's say. So, yeah. With that said, next we are going to go with the Giants taking, where's he at? Siaki Ika. A bit of a different pick. They do have Dexter Lawrence, but, you know, big guys on the interior, guys who can just clog up the run lanes. I think that's a great way to just start building your defense and being, you know, a true, really powerhouse position. And then we're going to have the Cowboys taking Isaiah Foskey. He's an edge rusher, but, you know, you have Micah Parsons, but that allows Micah Parsons to play around more, and I think him on the outside being more of the, you know, 3-4 edge instead of a 4-3 that Dallas has, like with DeMarcus Lawrence, would be a little better, and I just think it fits for them. So getting a solid player to put along with Micah Parsons. After that, the Bills. They are going to take and stop the fall of Kelee Ringo. He is a big athlete, but just hasn't had a lot of he doesn't have the safety net as most players. He's kind of raw in a lot of ways, and so getting a guy who, you know, has a lot of upside, but you have to work him up, I think it's a good addition for a team like Buffalo who has Tre'Davious White and a couple of veterans at safety and Micah Hyde and Jordan Poyer because they can, you know, teach him the ways of the position and whatnot before they need him. And then the Bengals. All right, so my computer decided to crap itself. So we had Kelee Ringo going right there. And then the Bengals take Jordan Battle. They lost Jesse Bates, and so, you know, got to replace that position. Carl Brooks is a really fun player, one of my favorite players in this draft class. He's 6'4", I believe, 300 pounds. Looks like a defensive tackle, but he's an edge. I mean, He's super quick, and I'm ready to see him play in the NFL. I want to see how that works. And then the Eagles take Tuli Tupelotu. I think that's how you say that. And, you know, they have guys like Brandon Graham, Fletcher Cox, who are going to be retiring soon. You can never have enough depth on those positions in the edge and the defensive line. So I think that's a good add for them there. And then Rashee Rice is a, you know, good little receiver from SMU. The Chiefs lost Juju and Mecole this offseason, and so they have to have some depth at that position. Rashee Rice will bring that. And so, yeah, that's my draft. Let me know how y'all feel about this in the comments. Tell me who you want your team to draft also at what position. And, you know, we're up to 215 subscribers. I know that's not a ton, but at the same time, I've only done this for like a month, and I feel like that growth in just a month is pretty solid. So I really appreciate you guys. Can't explain to you how much I do appreciate it. So thank y'all for watching, and peace.